This one is a big boy. Nothing cute about it. And it's sharp. Hey there everyone, mga kaibigan nating mahihilig sa matutulis at matatalas ng mga bagay. I have a video today about this blade. Isn't it gorgeous? Hindi siya cute. Medyo malaking blade ito. Kumpara natin sa mga usual blades na pinapakita natin. Ayan. So, this new blade of mine dwarfs this EDC knife from Ursulo. Ganyan siya kalaki. Now, I'm into bigger blades these days because there have been previous circumstances dito sa bahay that I needed to do something na nangangailangan ng medyo malaking blade. And, all I got here are yung mga EDC knives ko. So, I realized that I really need some bigger blades here as a utilitarian tool sa mga practical na paggagamitan dito sa bahay, a farm, or outdoors, not as a weapon, but itong mga gaya nito na very useful for heavier cutting purposes. So this is my tuna decapitator. Pinangalanan ko lang po ito, no? I gave it this name kasi nga I've been watching tuna cutting videos sa YouTube lately, and karamihan nakikita natin na ganito ang profile ng blades na ginagamit nila. Very effective in butchering, cutting down tuna and other big fishes. Let's get to the measurements. First, the blade length is 7.5. Ito, straight line ito. But if we measure this, itong cutting edge niya, pa-curve ito, probably this would be almost 9 inches. The handle is 5 inches. Just the right length for a one-handed grip sa blade na ito. At bago po tayo pumalaot sa video na ito at hindi pa po tayo nakapag-subscribe sa Clam Sharp Stuff, I would appreciate if you click that subscribe button, like the videos if you find them entertaining naman or useful. Alright, let's go on. This knife was forged sa Pandayan ng... First time ko ito, nagpa-forge sa pandayan ni Abelia. Dalawang pandayan ito na puro Abelia, no? Basta magkakamag-anak lang mga ito eh. And they are located in Mangahan, Turil, Davao City. The first time na tinanggap nila yung order ko, I don't know anong nakain ng mga yun. May lagnat ata. And I don't understand really bakit they're not that accommodating sa mga custom-made. No. I tried to explain to them na ako ay sinusubukan ko yung mga pandayan dito sa Davao City, and then if I can do a promotion para ma-promote yung mga products nila, para lang na sumikat naman ang blade communities, blacksmith community dito sa Davao City. But some of these guys really are medyo negative, reluctant, or maybe ayaw lang nila mag-deviate sa usual na ginagawa nila, which is making regular ordinary home and the farm tools, something like that. So yun, nagawa nila tayo ng isang blade, and as usual ito naman sila, ayaw naman nila gumawa ng finesse products, yung talagang pinong paggawa. So this is how the blade was delivered to me. There, very rough, and started reprofiling the blade because it's so-so. I had to refine the surface of the blade kasi medyo bako-bako yung daming mga sugat-sugat gawa ng grinder. Nilagyan ko ng grinds dito to serve as jimping para may traction naman pag pinatong mo yung thumb mo dito. I made a file work dito sa surface to serve as a design. I smoothened the surface, pinino natin ng konti, sanded it off up to 1,200 grit na sandpaper, and buffed it para kumintab. After buffing it, I gave it a mustard patina. Ito. So it looks different now. For the handle scale, I I installed a Nara handle scale. So ang ganda ng color, ang ganda ng grano texture niya. So I also gave it some contours to make it fit snugly sa kamay. Some grinding para to serve as traction. Kasi this is a working blade. You will hack into fish, you will hack into other materials, kung ano-ano pa man yan. And we need it to be secured sa ating kamay. Na hindi siya yung feeling na lilipad siya pag itinaga natin. So yan, I'm really, really happy about it. And I sharpened this blade into razor sharp na talas. Yan, very sharp. So if I'm gonna process fish with this one, it will not stand a chance. Okay, I have to wait for a big fish to come para masubukan natin ito. I posted this on Facebook and I received a lot of queries, no? Gustong umorder ng ganito. I don't really accept orders for these blades, but I thought of making a few more of this sana para sa mga dun sa mga medyo malapit sa atin, mapagbigyan naman natin. Kasi I got friends who are scuba divers. Sometimes they get big fishes and they want something to process it. Now, for the sheath, look at this pretty neat sheath na ginawa ng kaibigan kong si Joel Regala, Davao City. If you are from Davao City and you want some leather works na pulido, magandang pagkagawa, and not overly pricey, just contact the guy, Joel Regala. You can check his Facebook account and he will respond to you accordingly. I purposely designed this, this sheath para open. This side sa likod ay sarado siya. On this side naman, bukas siya para makita natin yung design natin sa blade, and at the same time, hindi siya talagang enclosed kasi tendency with leather sheaths is, it produces rust. I don't know. At kahit may lining na nga ito, sometimes nagkakalawang pa rin yung blades natin pag enclosed, totally enclosed siya sa leather sheath. So this would be a good thing to keep the moisture away, as long as hindi naman siya exposed sa mabasa, matalsikan ng tubig, ganyan. But anyway, we have to protect our blades naman. When we use it, we wash it with soap and water and then lubricate it. Especially these ones na gawa sa mulye. These are not rust resistant steel, so we gotta take good care of them. Okay? So I think that's about it. I hope these guys dito sa atin sa Davao City will improve their customer services. Otherwise, they make good products. Matibay naman. This one has been tested. I hacked into some hardwood and then sliced it back sa papel, and they remain sharp. No chips, no rolling on the edge whatsoever. So, they got good, the good steel processing. Nasubuhan ng maayos and matibay yung gawa nila. Kailangan lang siguro ng konting pino, pagandahin ng konti because they're kinda rough and hindi siya pogi, hindi siya pretty. Okay, so thank you very much once again, mga kaibigan, for watching. Stay safe, everyone. I'll see you next time.